Elijah was an awesome guy. Very bold. He took on 450 prophets of Baal. He made fun of them because their sacrifice wasn't received, while his was. But he probably got tired. Tired of fighting against their lack of belief, railing against their unfairness and injustices, their lack of respect for the real God. And he's sent on a journey, and he goes off, and he tires very quickly, and he lays down under a tree. And the shade provides him some place to rest, and he sleeps. And he's awoken, and right there is some bread and a jug of water that a messenger provides for him. And he takes and eats. And having eaten his full, the blood goes to his gut. And he gets tired again, and he goes back to sleep. And he gets up again from that sleep, and there's more bread, and there's more water. And he takes these in. And then the story goes that it was sufficient for him to travel 40 days to the Mount of Horeb, where he met and saw God. You have something more than Elijah. When I was 8 and I made my first communion, I went, you know, I opened my mouth, I stuck my tongue out at the time, went back to my place. My little white shirt and blue tie, blue slacks, closed my eyes. And I knew this was something very special. I thought of that in the words as we continue in the sixth chapter of John. That this communion that we receive is eternal life. Not for 40 days and 40 nights, but forever. Another thing I want to emphasize, it's not then that it happens, but now. You have within yourself now eternal life. You say, well, how can that be? Like St. Paul says, my outer self is wasting away, I'm dissipating, but the Lord is increasing in me, and my spirit is getting stronger. I know I will live always. What effect is it that the love of God that is between Jesus and the Creator is this gift that is given us? It's part of so many sacraments. When we had 92 young people confirmed this year, the bishop blessed the bread at the ceremony, blessed the wine, confirm them in this faith, but they received eternal life. People come to the altar to Mary, give their vows to each other, and ask God to be part of it in communion and have eternal life. a bond that can never be separated. Priests who are ordained and at every ordination of a Mass where they receive the sacrament of eternal life is given people. We anoint them on their forehead and on their hands, but very much a part of it, if possible, is viaticum, or the bread of eternal life, if they can receive. You have this here this morning in a special way. What effect should it have on you? How is it transforming you? I guess I would be so bold as to presume that maybe it should be changing me and making me give of myself all the more to others. Not that I can be Jesus, not that I can give myself to you, but in a sense we can. The effect of God visiting us and giving us eternal life should have an effect on all the unforgiveness and the errors and the animosity that exists in our world. This communion, this bread of eternal life, should have an effect. What effect is it having in your life? Is it changing you? Why do I need to receive it as often as I do? Because whenever we gather, whenever we offer our prayers, whenever we break open the scripture, it's new again. You are to be reborn today in eternal life in what you do. And I'm amazed because as a priest, I see the people come for communion, and they come, and some have difficulty getting up here, and some we have to take communion to. They hold out their hands, and some hands are real small, some are very big, some are stained by their work, some might have digits missing. The outer self is not as important as the inner self. And you are important, and God visits you. Give of yourself to others as you have been gifted yourself. Amen.